In the name of God, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful, get your accredited master's degree today with Bayan in Islamic Theology, Islamic Leadership, Islamic Chaplaincy, or in Islamic Studies. This top-tier institution opens the possibility of studying with renowned faculty members from around the world who are traditionally trained, alongside practitioners and academics from prestigious Western institutions, and all under one roof. Study each semester for 1 to 2 weeks on campus and finish the rest of your coursework online.
The students here at Bayan are actually teachers. They taught me a lot. I mean, I benefited from the discussion more than I really thought I would. I mean, each person brought a very unique perspective.
Join our growing network of students and graduates serving the needs of our communities as imams, leaders, chaplains, scholars, and the educators of tomorrow.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin wa bihi nasta'inu ala umuri dunya waddin. Salatu wassalamu ala rasulihil amin sayyidil awalina wal akhirina habibina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. And welcome back to our program, brothers and sisters, Our Common Humanity, a daily program on ITV with me, Imam Shamsi Ali. In today's episode, I would like to remind all of us that this worldly life is deeply challenging. The change happens from time to time. Yesterday, you could be rich. Tomorrow, you can be someone else. Changes happen in life. The circumstances happen, change from time to time. And hence, people oftentimes cannot handle it. We are deeply challenged. And so oftentimes people are so weak and become stressful in facing the challenges of life. But for Muslims, alhamdulillah, we know that our life is truly and wholly handled by the one who created us, the creators of the heavens and the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tabaraka alladhi biyadihi al-mulk. وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ Blessed is he in whose hands all the dominions, and he is powerful on all things. And so this faith, believing in the power of Allah and believing in the authority of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give us an immense strength in facing the challenge of life. In addition, certainly, because we do believe that life itself is naturally a test. And therefore Allah continues the ayah in Surah Tabaraka by saying, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا And the one Allah who created death and life to test whom among you best in deeds. In other words, that naturally, inherently, fundamentally, this life is a test itself. And as long as we are living our life, we are going to be tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that reason, when we are tested in any form, either it is something which is undesirable, something that we don't like, either it is sickness or poverty or any other challenge in life, we are in fully understanding that this is a part of our life, because life itself is a challenge. Particularly for the believers, we know that imams itself is a part of that process to be challenged. Allah says in the Quran, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا أَمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ Do people will be left believing, claiming to believe, claiming to be a believer, and يقولوا آمنا, claiming that they are believers. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, they are going to test them. حَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَنْ يُتْرَكُوا أَنْ يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ, and they are not yet tested. So they are going to be tested in order to know whom among them is honest in their faith and whom among is not really honest in their faith. لِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلِيَعْلَمَ الْكَاذِبِينَ, in order for Allah to know whom among them are honest in their faith and whom among them are really not honest in their faith. So iman is going to be tested. And sometimes the deeper iman that we have, the stronger iman that we have, the more challenging life that we are facing. To enter into the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not an easy job. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains that in the Quran, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ, do you think you will enter into the Jannah easily? أَن تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ وَلَمَّا يَعْلَمِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ جَاهَدُ مِنْكُمْ وَيَعْلَمَ الصَّابِرِينَ, and Allah doesn't know yet whom among you struggle, and doesn't know yet whom among is the patient. So Allah needs al-mujahada. Allah wanted to see al-jihad and mujahada in our life, that we struggle to be better, better in our faith, better in our ibadat, better in our akhlaq, and be patient in facing the challenges of life itself. Wa ya'lamu as-sabirin, patience in carrying out the commandments of Allah, patience in following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, patience in taking the responsibilities of life, patience in avoiding all that prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All this is a part of that process, a struggle, as part of our mujahad or jihad in order to enter into Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The next thing that makes a believer strong in facing the challenge of life, because we do believe in what we call al-hasanat and rewards in the patience and what we call ihtisab in Arabic language. For example, the patience of fasting. من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever fasts during the month of Ramadan with iman, with faith and ihtisab. And the meaning of ihtisab is calculating rewards, hoping rewards, thawab from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ, Allah is forgiving his sins for the past time. In other words, that ihtisab is necessary in order for us to be strong in facing the challenge. The more we are challenged and the more we are patient, the more rewards that Allah is going to give us. And remember about the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but all prophets of Allah. From Adam alayhi salatu wasalam to Noah alayhi salatu wasalam to Musa to Isa to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, they all faced tremendous challenge in their life, but they became strong and they became powerful in facing the challenges, and because of that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards them. The next reason why we can be strong in facing the challenge is that no matter how difficult the challenge that we are facing, no matter how challenging it is, we do believe at the end of the day, it's going to end. Because Allah says in the Quran, كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانْ, everything else perishes. So either it's good, either it is richness, either it is health, either it is power, all this is going to end. Or the opposite, either you are poor, sick, weak, marginalized, oppressed by others, believe me that at the end of the day, it goes, it's going to end. كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانْ. And naturally, this life itself is temporary. Everything is temporary, it's not permanent. So let's say we are sick. That sickness, at the end of the day, we are going to end it. It goes to end. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give us different situation, a better situation, inshallah ta'ala. The English people used to say, the American people used to say, at the end of the tunnels, there is always a shining light. You know, no matter how dark it is in the tunnel, no matter how long that tunnel is, at the end of the tunnel, there is a shining light. So similarly, our life, no matter how difficult it is, no matter how challenging it is, there will be an end and there will be a shining light, inshallah. It will be is inna ma'al usri yusra. Verily, along with the difficulty, there is an ease that Allah prepared for us. At any moment we are challenged, Allah opened the opportunity for us. Anywhere you have your challenge, Allah open for you an opportunity. And that's what it is that we believe based on the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Finally, why we are strong in facing the challenge of life? Because we do believe that there will be some time somewhere Allah is preparing for us better than what we are facing in this life. If we are poor, if we are weak, if we are unlucky enough in this life, because of the faith that we have, because of the iman that we have, we hope that somewhere, someday, and that is in Jannah, inshallah, we're going to have a better situation. And that's why all the mu'mins, the believers, always have hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, let's say you are the most unlucky person, the most unfortunate one. Poor, you know, weak, marginalized, nobody likes, everybody hate you. You know, you feel pain in this life. But that pain is temporary, number one. Secondly, that beyond that pain, there is a joy, there is a happiness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing for us. And so for the believers, we always being hopeful with that promise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that promise is Allah promised for us Jannah. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ. You know, in that Jannah, everything that you desire, everything that has been promised to you is prepared by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let me end with this story. One day, Imam Shafi'i was challenged by a Jewish person in Egypt. Because Imam Shafi'i was a very respectful, very honorable Imam, Sheikh. So one day he met a Jewish person that challenged him. He said, "Yes, Sheikh, O Imam Shafi'i, your Prophet Muhammad said that this world, this dunya, is sijin. This dunya is a jail for you, for me as a non-believer, and as for you, and a Jannah for me, a paradise for me. But how it is possible that your life is better than mine? If this dunya is a jail for you, supposedly that your life is worse than mine." So Imam Shafi is very intelligent, he's smart. And he responded to him saying, "That is true, that is right. I do believe in what the Prophet said." "Why?" the Jew said. "Because for you, no matter how difficult it is here in this dunya, in this world, compared to the nar, to the fire that Allah prepared for you in the akhirah, it is still Jannah for you. But for me, no matter how great it is, no matter how joyful it is, life for me here in this dunya, compared to what Allah prepared for me in Jannah, it is still nar, it is still jail for me. You know, I don't have it fully. It's just like jail for me, because compared to what Allah prepared for me in Jannah, inshallah." So that's the Muslim's hope, always hopeful that at the end of the day, and it is in Jannah, Allah prepared for us better, inshallah. جزاكم الله خير. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us. May Allah accept our fasting, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
In the name of God, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful, get your accredited master's degree today with Bayan in Islamic Theology, Islamic Leadership, Islamic Chaplaincy, or in Islamic Studies. This top-tier institution opens the possibility of studying with renowned faculty members from around the world who are traditionally trained, alongside practitioners and academics from prestigious Western institutions, and all under one roof. Study each semester for 1 to 2 weeks on campus and finish the rest of your coursework online.
The students here at Bayan are actually teachers. They taught me a lot. I mean, I benefited from the discussion more than I really thought I would. I mean, each person brought a very unique perspective.
Join our growing network of students and graduates serving the needs of our communities as imams, leaders, chaplains, scholars, and the educators of tomorrow.
ITV.